Everybody hates three putting, from recreational golfers to the most elite putters on the PGA Tour. People despise three putting. It's like giving away strokes on the green. But what's really interesting is that very few players misread a putt left or right by up to, say, 4 or 5 feet, but they will very oftentimes blow a putt 4 or 5 feet past the hole or leave one really, really short, which led the folks at Odyssey to try and develop a new way to try and help people improve their performance on the greens. The result of all of their work is these two putters right here, the new Ai-ONE and the Ai-ONE Milled. And while from the front, they may look like a lot of putters you've already seen, they have something very, very interesting on the inside that can potentially help you three putt a lot less often. Now I'm gonna start by talking about the standard Ai-ONE. And as you can see from the front, it has a white insert. And yes, this is a white hot insert that's been around for over 20 years. It's extremely popular. Has a very soft feel to it. It creates a very pleasing sound. In this particular case, there are a series of grooves on the front of that insert, but the real story in the Ai-ONE putters is on the back. You see, underneath the urethane coating on that insert is an aluminum piece that has been shaped using artificial intelligence. Odyssey's full swing arm, Callaway, has been using artificial intelligence for a number of years to create faces and drivers and fairway woods, and in some cases, other clubs as well. And that artificial intelligence in those full swing clubs has been used to optimize ball speed and to create more distance. Well, the folks at Odyssey programmed up those supercomputers to try and basically normalize the ball speed coming off of mishit putts. You see, when you strike a putt in the middle of the hitting area, you're gonna get the ball to roll out the ideal amount. But most players very often are going to be mishitting putts just a little bit towards the toe or just a little bit towards the heel. Even the best putters in the world mishit putts. So what the AI face does in the Ai-ONE putter is try and normalize the ball speed across a larger area of the face. And the computers did that by making thicker areas and thinner areas in the back of the insert. So the ball, again, gets normalized, gets the same speed across a much larger area. And when that happens, theoretically, you're going to get better distance control because you're going to get the same amount of roll from putts struck in a larger area of the face. This is the technology and this is the story that Jon Rahm was presented with a few weeks before the Ryder Cup, and is the reason why he went and made a putter change for the first time in a while. He had been using a standard Odyssey Rossi putter that in his case had a hinged, micro hinged face insert. Well, he was presented with the information about how much better this insert, the Ai-ONE insert, performs. The fact that according to Odyssey's research, golfers tend to have a 20% shorter leave distance when they don't make the putt using this putter insert. Well, Rahm was presented with that information and told that had he had an Ai-ONE insert in his putter, it would have been anticipated over the course of 2023 that he would have gone up in his performance in terms of strokes gained putting from ranking number 23 at the time of the presentation, which is fantastic, into the top 10. And he would have three putted less often. That would have translated in terms of dollars to winning about $2 to $2.5 million more prize money by taking out those three putts and turning them into two putts. That immediately got Rahm's attention, and that is the big reason why he made the switch before the Ryder Cup in Rome. Now, while there are many players that really like the white hot insert and certainly are going to be very interested in trying out the Ai-ONE insert technology, many of them also really prefer the feel and the sound that's going to be created from a classic milled putter. And for those players, they are in luck because there is a milled version of the Ai-ONE putter. It's going to be very easy to tell the two putters apart because the standard Ai-ONE putters have that white hot insert, and the milled putters are going to have this gold toned insert where the milling marks across the face are very, very easy to spot. I see also decided in the milled version not to include the window on the back, so you're not going to be able to see the AI face. You're not going to see in the milled putter the different ridges and grooves and thicker areas and thinner areas on the back like you will see it in the standard Ai-ONE. From a fitting standpoint, both putters have weights on the bottom that are not really designed to be adjusted by consumers, but they are there for fitters so that they will be able to swap out those weights and put in heavier weights or lighter weights based on either a player's preference or on the putter's overall length, if they can get the swing weight just where it needs to be. And as I'm sure you can probably anticipate, there are going to be several different head versions of these putters, both the standard Ai-ONE as well as the Ai-ONE milled, that are going to be available, from heel-toe weighted blades of various sizes and thicknesses to relatively compact mid mallets and larger mallet putters as well. So obviously Odyssey sent me these two putters ahead of time and allowed me to take them out on the golf course and give them a try. And here are my initial thoughts. Number one, if you're somebody who's been using an Odyssey putter that has a white hot insert, you are going to probably be able to transition into the Ai-ONE, the standard Ai-ONE, very, very easily, because the white hot insert creates a very unique sound and feel. I've been using a traditional milled putter for a long time, And whenever I use the white hot putters, I find that the sound is softer, the feel is softer, and that just takes a little bit of getting used to. Let me be really clear about this. It's not a bad sound. It's not an off-putting sound in the least. It's just a little bit different than what I'm used to. And since sound and feel are so interrelated when it comes to putting, and feel and distance control also have a huge relationship to themselves, it might take a little bit of getting used to if you transition from a milled putter into the standard Odyssey Ai-ONE, which was why I think it's a very smart move for them to create the Ai-ONE milled. Transitioning for me into the Ai-ONE milled would be very, very easy. The sound, the feel, it's a little bit higher pitch sound. It's a little bit louder sound, especially on full swinging longer putts. And it was something that I was much more used to. As far as the distance control claim, I think it's very, very difficult to, with the limited amount of testing that I've been able to do so far, be able to say that yes, definitively, the Odyssey claim about leaving putts 20% closer to the hole with your leave is going to be valid. I don't doubt their research in the least. They have to legal up on a lot of that stuff. But it's hard to tell when you strike a putt and you know that you mishit it, if it should have stopped, say, 5 feet from the hole or 4 feet from the hole. Did I get a little bit of extra roll out of that? It's really hard for me to gauge at this point. I do believe that an artificial intelligence insert could probably be really beneficial, that it can normalize ball speed across a larger portion of the face. And anytime you can build in forgiveness in a traditional looking putter, I'm here for that 100%. I'd be very curious to try out some of the mallet putters as well, because I think that if you combine the forgiveness of a mallet with a more forgiving insert, that could be the recipe for a lot of really good things, especially for players who really struggle with distance control on the greens and hit it all over the face. It sounds like it should make a lot of sense. In the address position, I found both this standard Ai-ONE double wide as well as this Ai-ONE milled 1T. I really liked the dark finish. I like the fact that there was a single alignment line. I think the look is classic if you're somebody who really likes a dark finish putter. There's nothing not to like when it comes down to the new Odyssey Ai-ONE lineup. So now you know why Jon Rahm switched putters and went to a new Odyssey Ai-ONE putter right before the Ryder Cup, as well as Sam Burns. He put an Odyssey Ai-ONE number 7 in play at the Tour Championship. It was this technology that really spurred them to making those changes. Listen, if you're curious about the Ai-ONE, if you've got questions about the Ai-ONE, please drop them in the comment area below. I will look forward to answering any questions you might have about these putters. If you're curious about them, if you're thinking that this might be a technology that could help you, I want to hear about it. And after you have an opportunity to hopefully try one of these for yourself, I'll be really interested to hear from people just like you about whether you feel that this putter is going to give you better distance control, whether that face technology is going to help you when you don't make the putt, leave it closer to the hole so that you can avoid three putting. I'll be fascinated to hear what regular golfers like you have to say about this. Look, I hope if you got some good information out of this video, you'll consider subscribing to my channel as well as hitting that bell button. It really helps, and it also tells you when I've got new content coming out. We're into the fall here and the early winter stuff is coming, but there are going to be a lot of really, really exciting drops and new pieces of equipment coming in the weeks ahead. You are not going to want to miss it. So thanks a lot, and I look forward to seeing you soon.